It looks like we are in a constant race. Like we're never fully satisfied. We always try to look ahead, completely ignoring the now. And the more we receive from this life, the more we want, never reaching the satisfaction. Is it just the way we are as humans? Well, I am definitely not a perfect guru who knows everything about life and who is in a absolute harmony or peace with myself, but I have spent pretty much time rebuilding my mindset, rethinking the purpose of me on this earth, and I acquired a few things that I would like to share with you because those things are pretty important to know about. And please do not underestimate my age. Yes, I'm young, but it's just a number. You know, everybody's story is different, and my story is pretty much an exception from stories of, you know, people of my age, the majority of them. So I have a lot of things that I can share, that I can give you all as a message that you can think about. I'm different from a template, and I want you to understand it before you start listening or watching to this video or any other of my videos. I want you to take me seriously. Thank you for that, and let's begin. And at first, let me refer to my story. So I started out my mindfulness journey as a lost kid who was mad at life, who was sad and disappointed. Many of you actually know about that period of my life. If you haven't watched the burnout video, you should before you begin watching this video, you know, to better understand my story. I will leave it here somewhere or also down below, so check that out if you haven't yet. Sure thing, I needed to somehow get out of that state of mind, and I started educating myself. At first, I added up some yoga and meditation into my life, gradually increasing the length and, difficulties of my practices. In parallel, I have been learning a lot about nutrition and health and how foods can change us. And also, not so long ago, actually, I fully transitioned to vegan diet. You know, I always knew that I needed to do something for this earth and for myself as well, because, you know, we're all connected here and we're all together in it. So I have become more aware of all of the environmental problems and global issues, and I want to understand others as well. I mean, other species. I want to be respectful, not only to other humans, but also to other species, to other animals, and I support them. And by being plant-based, I'm being supportful. And also, it's not about eating, but it's also about sustainability. I try not to use plastic as much as I can, and, you know, other things that I can do to reduce the waste. And, you know, overall, I fell in love with living, with being on this planet, with breathing every day and being able to do things that I do every day. And I'm grateful for my health, I'm grateful for my brain, for my mindset, for my knowledge, and etc., etc. And of course, once again, I'm not perfect and I don't have a perfect mindset. I'm not a perfect person. I also make mistakes in, being myself. I also think in bad ways. Sometimes I do not think as positively, but I try to do my best. And this is the goal, you know, for all of us, trying to do our best. And I try to enjoy the journey, not the imagined destination. And also, I would like to share the examples of, you know, my little things, the things that I do every single day, the things that make me, you know, happier, that make me more satisfied every single day. And the first thing is my morning routine. You know, morning is an essential part of every day, and as I think, the most important part, because in the morning you have a chance to set the intention for a day. No matter what happened yesterday, no matter what, you know, will happen later, you can do it now. You can do it in the morning. And I have some rituals that I do pretty much every single morning that help me set my intention. Educating myself. Like I said before, I really enjoy educating myself in all ways possible. You know, besides books or schools or some kind of education institutions, we also have such an amazing resource as internet. If you use it right, you know, taking all the advantage, you can gain so much knowledge from it. Cooking. Being plant-based automatically makes you cook more because you don't have so many options eating with your family if you're not vegan, like in my situation, or you cannot eat out all the time either because you don't have enough money like I do, and or just if you don't have enough, you know, vegan places around. I absolutely enjoy cooking, and I love discovering new recipes, original unique recipes. You know, I love those short Instagram videos. I have the whole collection of them on my Instagram. Yeah, those are pretty simple and fun to experiment with. Exercising. I cannot imagine a day without, you know, moving my body, without exercising. Either it is a complete gym, you know, workout, or yoga, or just at home workout, or maybe just walking. You know, I have to do something every single day, at least something. Without it, I do not feel, you know, happy. I do not feel satisfied. So some kind of movement, and you will see the difference. Journaling. Putting your emotions and feelings that you've been carrying with you throughout your day feels amazing. If it's something negative, you can just let it go, leave it on your paper, or if it's something positive, you'll have some memories, you know, when you will read your notes in the future. I do not journal every single day yet. It's a habit that I'm still, you know, introducing into my lifestyle, but it feels amazing. And you know, also such things as doing my art, painting, spending time with my family, or like with my friends, or even like running my social media. I enjoy it so much. I love posting for you guys. I love writing informative content for you. I love filming my videos. You know, I can come up with some genius ideas like this one and share it with the world, and it's great. My point is, you should get rid of the obsession of, you know, thinking about the future all the time. Or, let me paraphrase, start to enjoy the journey towards your future. Try to be happy right now, not then. Think of what you can do every single day to make yourself happier now. What are your little things?